Today, Rick. What are we on today?
Bad power, a physical day. Brad's sparring in Liverpool. I'm sparring Brett in a bit, so I'm just going to have a move about with Chloe on the pad. She's fighting Friday. We'll just do a physical on the ground.
Enjoying it?
Yeah.
You said to me there just before we started that you might be potentially looking at turning over in September.
Yeah.
Yeah, tell us about that.
Yeah, we're not sat down proper yet and decided like, what we're going to do, but ideally I'd like to be out in September. Hopefully this time holds up alright, have no more problems with it, and yeah, we'll be good to go.
Tell me why now the decision to turn over at the age of 23?
Just because in, when was it, March, in the championships, I went in it, won my semi, then after the fight, that was the start of it, after the fight, my hand went, I didn't say nothing. A week later, I was meant to be fighting on a Friday, and Ricky and Blaine decided to pull me out, just because it weren't looking too good. So that was championships over for me, but my plan was do the championships, get through them, and then turn over. I thought, I'm not waiting another year now, I want to do it, but yeah.
So enjoying training here over at Ricky, so you're working with Ricky and Blaze.
Yeah,
great. And give us, before you carry on, just tell us your main strength as a fighter.
Say jab. Yeah. I work a lot off my jab.
Yeah. Alright, well we're gonna see.
Yeah.
Friday.
Four
sleeps.
Friday.
Next couple of weeks.
Liverpool, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so you're looking in good shape and everything.
Yeah.
How are you feeling going into this?
Good, yeah. You know, made up as well to be fighting Liverpool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the headline by Nathan Gorman, I think, isn't it?
Yeah, that's the one.
Yeah, so you get to fight in front of your home crowd so early in your career. That's good, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. Something I'm really looking forward to. Something that I, you know, really wanted to do when turning over, and now I'm doing it on my first fight, so.
Nice. And what we can expect to see from your big performance on the night?
Yeah, a good performance. You know, I've been working hard, so you know, hopefully it'll all show on the night.
And what do you make of Ricky's weight loss as well? Because I've just seen today, it looks like literally like the old Ricky Hatton.
Yeah, I know. He was sparring Campbell as well on Friday, and it's mad how much they look alike. Obviously now he's lost all that weight, but you know, it's good. It's inspiring because you know, flick that switch and then look at him now.
Brilliant. And just on you and your own career, are you getting any tips off Ricky about, you know, the nutrition side of things? Because he's shed it so quick.
Hopefully I don't have to do it like how he does it. But yeah, you know, if I do put on that much weight, I know who to ask.
Yeah, exactly. But you look in good calm mood and everything going into this one. Are you just excited about being out and you know, back under the lights again?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it's fight week now, so all you can do is be calm and be ready for the night, because all the hard work's been done. So yeah, I'm ready to go.
Brilliant. Right, well, I'll let you get back to training. But yeah, cheers.
Cool. Thank you.
Charge it. But if you step off and go like that, still get your breather like that. Makes him scared of coming in. You get your bite yourself time. If he sees you bouncing, huffing and puffing, are you with me?
Basically, I've been coming down here now I think when I first spoke to you, I was down here about 2 or 3 months, but been here 18 months now. But I think we spoke to Blaine and that and Ricky, and we're going to turn over at the end of the summer, because I think the training that I'm doing now, it's obviously longer rounds, a slower pace. I think my style will suit that in the future, so we made that decision a few weeks ago.
When I first met you, you were very, very baby-faced. You're still baby-faced, yeah. But you're definitely filling out and stuff. How have you felt that the journey's gone over the last couple of years?
Yeah, well, 2 times a week, we do strength for conditioning here. So doing that now for over a year, obviously you can see the effects of it inspiring in that, because when you turn pro over them long rounds, you can't just dance about, you know, you have to be strong and use your strength, you know, to get through it. So I think that has definitely benefited me on the strength side, yeah.
So turning over, a lot of the people in the gym I spoke to here, the prospect coming through, well, I spoke to Bayern there, he's turning over as well. So you're going to have a few people with you on the journey as well.
Yeah, definitely, because I think Brad's had the most fights and he's closing in on titles now. But like Ibby and Chloe and Brett, they're all just a little bit ahead of me. So if I'm keeping up with them in the gym, then that's only going to push me on further, innit?
And what are you on today then? Doing a bit of sparring or just pads and stuff?
Not sparring today, no. We're just doing apparatus, so bag, prowler, pads, more like a conditioning session. Then we'll do some ab work at the end.
All right, mate. Nice one. I'll let you get back on.
Cheers, mate.
Yeah, July 21st.
July 21st?
3rd.
23rd, yeah, that's on Kevin Marie's show, isn't it, yeah?
Yeah.
You looking forward to it?
Yeah, been a while since I had my last fight now, because obviously I had Ramadan, so I had it off.
You know that fight, though, in particular, the fight at the AJ Bell Stadium, you showed a lot of character, because you went over bad on your knee, didn't you?
Yeah.
And you carried on and you stuck it out, so what was going through your mind when that happened?
Oh, just obviously one more round to go, just get the win and carry on with it.
Yeah, you do, you get on with it. You've had two fights since then. You're very active, aren't you, as a fighter?
Well, apart from during COVID, yes, since after that I've been quite active.
And then back out again in July. So what things that you think feel you've improved on in the last few months?
It's like a bit of everything really. Like staying more composed, taking my time. Because when I started off, I was rushing like in and getting hit with stupid shots. Whereas as the fights have gone on, not really got hit with as many shots and been more smart with it.
You're quite exciting to watch though. You like letting them combinations go.
Yeah.
Is that something we're always going to see from you though? Just you love getting involved a little bit.
Yeah, probably. As the rounds go on, I get more involved because it's used to it from the amateurs, so it's kind of in my style.
Yeah. And are you enjoying it?
Yeah.
Enjoying it.